Hey everybody, welcome to another episode of 60 Formula. Hope you're doing well today. Happy Friday, it's TGIF, dude. It's the end of the week, which means it's time to party down like a clown, Charlie Brown.
He's like, dude, I don't even know what you're saying or what you're talking about. You're speaking humish. I don't even know that language. I speak dogish.
Holy schmagoli, this week was one of the craziest weeks that we've had in such a long time. So for everybody that lives in the United States, we had Thanksgiving, baby. Ooh, and it was delicious. And both the Siberian Huskies, myself, and Rue had an absolute great holiday. Now, not only did we celebrate Thanksgiving, dude, but we also celebrated my birthday. Yeah, I had a birthday party. We just relaxed, and at the end of the day, I went to Dave and Buster's, baby. Oh, that's right, I played all the games my way. I did Guitar Hero, we played the Luigi's Mansion game, I did this Halo game. Hila's like, dude, I'm not even interested because you didn't invite me to the Dave and Buster's, so I don't really care. Oh, but dang, dude, I wish you could have came because it was super duper awesome. It was thebest.com. Now, on today's episode, we're bringing you some knowledge, some stuff you can cram into your head and get smarter and stuff. Yeah, that's right. You're going to get smarter. You're going to gain a little bit of experience. Can I get a high five, bro? Heck yeah, Deuteroni. Typically, we talk about all the good stuff when it comes to these fluffy Siberian Huskies, but today we're going to be talking about three ways how you can tell if your Siberian Husky is sick or not feeling good. I know. It's the last thing we want to talk about, but it's really important to know that if you're going to get a Siberian Husky, if you're going to raise one of these Flufferoni pizzas, you got to know when they're not feeling well and when they're sick,
so that you can immediately ride them on over to the veterinarian and get them clinical care ASAP.
He's like, I don't know anything you just said, Daddy-O, but you better have a treat at the end of this video or I'm gonna sit on your pillow with my butt.
So we're all familiar with the fact that Siberian Huskies are majestic. They're beautiful. They're wonderful, sometimes overweight creatures.
I'm not talking about you. I'm sorry. I wasn't talking about you. I know, you didn't... That wasn't a face of approval, was it? Now, you may be thinking to yourself, 60, come on, dude. It's really easy to tell when a dog doesn't feel well or when a dog's sick. Do you really need to make a video about it? Well, let me tell you something, friend. Siberian Huskies are infamous for not letting you know when they don't feel good, when they're hurt, and when they're sick. And they do this on purpose because they're a pack animal. And naturally, when pack animals get hurt or they're sick, they don't display it physically because they don't want to alert their other pack members that, hey, I'm the weakest link, dude. So it is common for Siberian Huskies to hide the fact that they don't feel good or they are hurt.
So as an owner, you must be responsible. You must take charge and look for the signs to make sure that your Dogaroni pizza is A-OK 100%.
So without further ado, we bring to you three ways that you can tell that your Siberian Husky is sick or does not feel good. Are you guys ready? Okay. Then let's get it done. Alright, let's jump right into the information. What are some of the first signs that you should be looking for whenever you're trying to figure out if your Siberian Husky is sick? The first thing that you should look for whenever you're looking for these kinds of signs is lethargic behavior. Anytime your dog is sleeping far more than usual, maybe they're just laying down and being lazy way more and you're noticing it, this is a sign that your doggo may not feel well. Dogs that experience a lot of sleepiness and are lethargic typically do not feel well or could even possibly have an injury. The reason they become lethargic is because sitting down and staying still is the only way for them to feel any sort of relief or a way to escape the pain, so this is what they do. It's pretty similar to humans. Anytime you don't feel well, you probably lay down on the couch or lay down in bed and you sleep a lot. This is the same case for dogs. So if you're wondering if your dog is sick or you think that they're not feeling well and they're sleeping a lot and you can't even get them to get up and get excited with stimulation, this is probably a sign that your Siberian Husky does not feel well. The second question you should ask yourself whenever you're wondering if your Siberian Husky is feeling well is, are they eating food? One thing dogs do, especially Huskies, when they start to get sick or not feel well, is they stop eating or they don't eat as much. Now listen, Siberian Huskies are infamous for being picky with food, so just because your Husky doesn't eat their meal, it doesn't necessarily mean they're sick. But if your dog consistently doesn't eat things that they're typically attracted to, they're not eating their regular meals for a couple days, this is a sign that your Siberian Husky probably does not feel well. And when you accompany this with the tiredness and lethargic behavior, you can start to crank up that I'm pretty sure my Siberian Husky is sick meter. Let's move on over to number three, and see the last sign that you should look for when you're trying to figure out if your doggo doesn't feel well. He's like, does it have to do with my butt? Yeah, it does. Unfortunately. And last but not least, we're gonna be talking about the potty. Oh yeah, the butt stuff. If your Siberian Husky is going out to the bathroom every 2 seconds and they're having some, what they call runny water poo-poo, the diarrhea. I'm talking about the waterfalls, bro. If your Siberian Husky can't stop bending over and doing the squirts, that's a definite sign that they do not feel good. Dogs that have diarrhea not only are losing water and becoming dehydrated, it also probably means that your dog has some sort of bug inside them that's making them go to the bathroom, or they ate something bad. Now, on the flip side, if your Siberian Husky isn't going to the bathroom at all, that's a completely other problem, but same thing. Your Husky is probably not feeling well. Whenever your Siberian Husky doesn't go to the bathroom for a very long time, they may even be going outside and hunching over, but nothing's coming out. This may mean that they have something lodged or something stuck in their intestines, which can be very dangerous and needs immediate medical attention. So just be sure to look out for these signs. If your Siberian Husky is sleeping all the time, if they are not eating or refuse to eat whenever they have an appetite, and they're pooping way too much or not pooping at all, these are the signs to look for if you're trying to make sure that you got a healthy dog. Britney Spears is like, dude, I poop just fine, dude. I don't know about you. I'm the most perfect pooper on planet poop. You're weird, dude. You weird. So those are the three things to look out for whenever you're trying to figure out if your Siberian Husky is sick. I know this video was super silly, but it's super important to make sure you're paying attention to all these things whenever you own one of these super cute snow dogs. We had a blast hanging out with you guys today. A lot of stuff is changing. Check out the playlist down below on our YouTube channel. You'll notice we're starting to rearrange a whole bunch of different things just to help you guys find training videos and other videos a whole lot quicker. If you had a blast today, be sure to smash that like button and hit subscribe so you don't miss out on any more Huskaroni Pizza episodes. And until next time, we'll see you with another episode of Guess What? Yeah, that's right. Whatever we make. Peace! He's like, no, dude. You can't do it if you make a fart noise. All right, come on. Welcome to another episode of 64formula.com. Hey everybody, welcome to another episode of 64formula.com. Hey everybody, welcome to another episode of 64formula.com.